Hi everyone, welcome back to SFDC Panther. And here in this session, we are going to talk about another important topic, that is Mulesoft. We will talk about what Mulesoft is, what is a Mule ESB, and why it is a big deal in these days. So let's start with what is Mulesoft, what is a Mule ESB, and what are its important topics, important features that we will be learning in our coming sessions. So what is a Mule ESB? Mule ESB is basically a lightweight Anypoint platform that is completely built on Java that enables a developer to integrate different applications together in a very quick and easy way that exchange the data from one system to another system in different formats like JSON or XML. And it also we can also integrate different systems regardless of what kind of technology they are using. Either it might be a .NET technology, it might be a Java application, or it might be some Java scripting framework, or it might be some SaaS application, some mainframe application, some FTP, or some IoT devices. So we can integrate with multiple applications, and we can make those applications to work together in order to complete a particular product, or in order to increase the productivity of a product. So this is a very basic introduction about, and going forward we will see what was the problem in a legacy integration, that was point-to-point integration, and then what was the solution with our Mulesoft application network or API-led connectivity that Mulesoft talks about. So earlier we have a point-to-point integration for the legacy systems, like we have some Oracle database, we have some MySQL database, we have some mainframe systems, some SaaS-based applications like Google, Microsoft, Salesforce, and then we have some order management API, we have some shopping cart API, or we have some email systems, emailing API, we have some IoT devices, we have box.com, we have some FTP servers, we have some REST or web-based services. So if you are working for a single organization that is a very small organization and which don't have that much applications that needs to be connected in order to work together, that is it will look like a very simple point-to-point integration will look like a very simple and easy to manage. But once the system increases, it looks like a very messy system. Here if you can see in this picture, we have a multiple system that is very messy. This system are trying to connect with each other based on point to point. One SOAP API service is consuming database, getting some data for the customers, and then again sending back to the data to the our web application or mobile application. So here if you see that we have different systems. We have big data, mainframes, then we have WebSphere, we have SAP, FTP, Workday, we have Sugar CRM, we have JMS, we have databases, different types of databases. And here on the top left, we have SOAP APIs, REST API, email services. We have some CMS connects like WordPress. And then we have some SaaS-based applications like Google, Salesforce, Amazon, Microsoft. So in this case, managing the integration is a very big thing. If there is anything is broken, then the complete there is a possibility of breaking the complete application, and there are multiple things that that can happen behind the scene whenever we are let's say that if you wanted to change a particular application, you wanted to change a particular service, then for that you have to change the application layer and the presentation layer as well. So to overcome all these problems, Mulesoft comes with the things that is called as API-led connectivity, which talks about different things, and it talks about different APIs. We divide the API in three different layers, like system API, processing API, and then experience API. So this is a thing that Mulesoft talk about, so that is API-led connectivity. So if we talk about from top to bottom, we will say that these are the system of records. So we have different systems here. We have CMS, we have Workday, we have SAP, IoT devices, we have Salesforce itself here, FTP server, we We have some web-based services. We have Java service, Java messaging services. We have Oracle. We have some payment processing APIs like Stripe, PayPal, Authorize.net, and then we have some Box.com. There might be multiple systems. There might be hundreds of these systems or thousands of these systems. Because every company wants to grow, so they may definitely have a different system. So what Mulesoft does, a person who knows this backend system comes ahead and designs some APIs that is called as process API. So what it does, it takes the information from a backend and designs an API that is called, we can say, as a customer API. So let's say that if you wanted to get data for a customer, you can use this customer API instead of directly going to the system and finding which system is holding the information about the customer. And then when we talk about order processing, so if you want to, you are using an e-com site and you have some order processing system embedded there for your product, then you can use order processing API instead of going either there in the bottom system of records. And if you are using payment processing, you can use payment processing API. You can use return for your orders return API. You can also say there are multiple feedback APIs, or there can be a multiple process APIs. So let's take an example. Your developers are building a product, and so they want the information about the customer. Instead of going and finding all this information over here, you can just provide an API to your customer. Say that this is the API and that you need to use to get the customer data. You don't need to worry about what is happening in the backend and which system is holding all those information about the customer. And same thing, you can talk about order processing, you can talk about feedbacks, you can talk about payment processing, and you can also talk about order returns. Are there any other processes? And then after that, you can also build an experience API that we can say experience for the user experience. That will be a mobile API, mobile API, or it can be a web-based API. So if a developer is working for an, you can say that there is a developer who is working for iOS or Android application that needs to use all these system, all this information like customer API, order processing, payment API, or return API, or any feedback, other processing APIs. You can directly provide this API to your developers and say that use this API and you will get all information, you will get all the endpoints, you will get all the data that you want for your customer, and then you can build an application for iOS or Android to show the user experience, to show the users for how it will look like, and instead of interacting with this system of records. And same thing you can consider for the web-based API. So these are all three level of APIs. You can see system API, the bottom on the bottom it contains the base record, that we can say system of records, and then we have processing API for processing the information, and then we have experience API for our user experience. And all these you can provide to your developers to work with, and they can integrate different system in a very quick and easy way. They don't need to worry about. So now if there is some requirements that you need to make changes in your either in a customer API or in a processing API, then a person who designed this API can make those changes here from the backend, and then developer don't need to be panic about their user experience or about any additional changes over their code. So all these all together known as application network, and this is all about that Mulesoft talk about application API led connectivity. And so next we will see what we have, what are the advantages of Mule ESB. So as we already discussed, that Mule ESB is a very lightweight that is completely developed on Java, and it is using XML and Spring based framework for designing the application. It is highly scalable, we can say, easy to maintain, and we can very easily We can very quickly develop the application. It is also loosely coupled with the system because we are not using point-to-point integration. And the best thing that it supports SOA, that is service-oriented architecture. So what does SOA means? It explains itself in its name. It is saying that we are not going to deploy the complete application. We are just going to deploy a single service. So let's say that you have an example and you wanted to change some user presentation layer for user experience. Then you can change. Then a developer can easily go to there and use this, make use of this experience API and change their presentation layer instead of worrying about how the data is being flowed from the system of records to process API and all that. And then we are only deploying simple service. We are not deploying the complete application to our client. So that particular service will only get affected instead of the, affecting the complete application. And then it also provides the unified solution for connecting the multiple application, you know, from a single, and we can also design our own API. And then it can also be deployed to either on-premise or on cloud. That means if your requirement is to run your service in your system itself, in your server, then you can use option for option of on-premise. Or if you wanted to execute, or if you wanted to make your service available to your partners, to your customers, then you can execute or you can run your service on cloud. And the best thing about Mulesoft is it provides a separate cloud. Like we upload our, we deploy our services, we deploy our application to Cloud Hub, that provides a separate cloud workers for each and every application that has its own limited, that has its own bandwidth, its own processes, its own all its working. So whenever you are deploying a particular application on cloud, it is associated with a separate cloud workers which will only work for your for that particular application. So this is a basic thing about what Mulesoft is and what is Mule ESB. In our next video, we will see how we can install Mulesoft Anypoint Studio in your system for working from your system, and we will also talk about what are all the components of Mulesoft Anypoint Platform. Thank you.